Hello, everybody, and welcome to Mr. Oz's Fish Room. I'm just doing an update right now on my planted 55-gallon, and it's a little overgrown. It could use some cleaning, but I just wanted to get a little footage, especially now with my Corydoras going crazy. Springtime. These are my celestial pearl danios. Got one little Severum Rock Teal in here because he's too small to be with the other Severums, and I want him to live, so he's kind of in here for his own good. Growing slow, but he's growing. Got my rose line sharks in here. I had to move everything into this tank. Got my Corydoras going crazy. Springtime. Crazy. I hope there's more than one female in there, that's for sure. Looks like there's two, so maybe there's a little bit of a balance. The rose lines are doing really well. Kind of had their own tank for a while. And the plants are doing quite well. And got my cherry barb still. This big bush of Rotelia is a little bit out of control, but I need it to be overgrown right now just because there are so many fish in here that I need to provide plenty of protection and room for hiding for all the various fish, and probably need to remove some fish. And I need to increase my filtration as well. Right now I have enough filtration for a 70-gallon tank, but I'm going to bump it up to probably around 110, so it's twice what I need for the tank. I'm always into over-filtration. Unless it affects a plant tank, Corydoras are just nuts right now. Spawning. My cherry barbs are just cruising along. I really like the cherry barbs, I have to say. They're so mellow. They are, for that reason, as well as being a beautiful fish. I mean, that red on red is just, it's gorgeous. We've got, it's a really good looking fish. Good symmetry. Even the females, they're beautiful. And as I've said before, I just threw my neons in here to kind of add a little bit of an element to the tank, and it's coming along nicely. And back up to the Celestial Pearl Danios. This is what it's all about. Just watching my fish and relaxing and seeing those leaves curl up with CO2. Obviously there's a little bit of a algae bloom going on here, but I will be addressing that in the next day or two. I've been super busy. If you own Corydoras, then you can really appreciate them. They are a hoot. Then I've got my rummy heads in here. They're super mellow, but it's probably a little bit too crowded in here right now. So they're not really schooling, but they are hanging out. They're congregating in the same area, so that's probably just as well, but they're not in their ideal environment, because if they were, they would be schooling. So, but I just wanted to cover my tank here and make sure we got some good coverage to share. This is my MixMax. I've covered it before. It's an Ixta product, and it's a CO2 diffuser reactor. It breaks up the bubbles, arguably better than a Sergis reactor. Yeah, somebody will always argue that, I'm sure, but look at the tank. It's growing all right, you might say. So, argue, but the tank is growing, so I'm going to stick with the MixMax, and if I get a tank where it needs to be hidden, because this tank is definitely not a for-show tank, it's more like an experiment, because it's my first planet tank. I made so many mistakes with it, and so many adjustments that I just kind of had to see where things go. Now in the future, I'll know how to hide my different devices, and I'll most likely be going with the sumps. My S-Repens is doing great. I have to clean it up every once in a while because of the algae. And like I said, not to repeat myself, but I need to deal with the algae in here. So, this is my UV sterilizer. 9 watts is what I'm running right now. And here's a little 80 gallons per hour pump. It's just in there to train the valve so that it doesn't get too wrapped around the filter. And it's so small, it does create some flow, but again, you know, I really don't think I'm losing a whole lot of CO2. No matter where I put my bubble counter, it's happy and green. So I'm not even using it right now. Some really cool fishing here.